Salzburg, bisected by the river Salzach, is a delight from first sight. A soft light bathes the shapes of its towers and churches in a wonderful setting, and its picturesque streets with their wrought iron signs, its spacious squares with sculpted fountains, and the noble architecture of its buildings, inspired by bishops with a passion for construction, leave memories which linger for years. The visitor is well catered for with relaxing transportation to enjoy the beautiful city. The fountain in the center of the residence plots, erected around 1660, is considered the largest Baroque fountain north of the Alps, and with its horse motive, it seems quite fitting that the real horses and buggies are stationed almost alongside. In the Domplatz, the statue of the Virgin stands in front of the huge Baroque cum Italian Renaissance Cathedral, the pediment of which is crowned with a figure of Christ, flanked by the statues of Moses and Elijah, while below them are the figures of the four apostles. In the residence plots, every Sunday morning is a food and flower market, both gay and colourful. Of course, we can't forget that Salzburg gave birth to Mozart, considered by many the greatest composer the world has known, whose music delights high and low brows alike. The Getreidegasse is one of the chief streets of Old Salzburg, and like the rest of the old town, it is narrow and lined with 5- and 6-story houses. A lively shopping street, it is adorned with many wrought iron signs which provide a picturesque touch. In this street, at number 9, stands Mozart's birthplace, where the family lived on a third floor flat from 1747 for 26 years. National costume is more than conspicuous in this city, being worn by young girls and older women alike. During one morning of our stay here, there was a demonstration by cyclists demanding the removal of all motorized transport from the city. No doubt every country has its pressure groups who can only see their own point of view. From the balcony of Tomaselli's cafe, we look down on the Alte Marktplatz, or Old Marketplace. A visit to an Austrian or a Bavarian city is never complete without a visit to the local theatre to enjoy coaching and dancing, which is very often performed by amateur groups attempting to perpetuate this form of musical art. the pleasure palace of Hellbrunn, standing in enchanting surroundings, was built by Marcus Siticus, Prince Archbishop of Salzburg, and completed about 1615. The tour of the water gardens begins in the Bacchus Court. We pass alongside a pond where fine goldfish disport themselves in clear water. In the centre of the court is a stone table. On summer evenings, we are told, the Archbishop would invite the court and his huntsmen to garden soirees. If in the course of the evening the company became too merry, the Archbishop would sign to his servant, who turned a hidden tap, causing a jet of water to spout from each stool. Etiquette demanded that no one rise until the Archbishop did so. His stool remained dry. Guess who is spitting into whose mouth? The most recent addition to the water toys of Hellbrunn, and perhaps the most fascinating, is the mechanical theatre. It was commissioned in 1750. In the arched recess, we see the everyday life of a small Baroque township with all its burghers and craftsmen. The mechanism is to a large extent still the original one, and like all the other tricks in Hellbrunn, water driven. This golden crown is raised and lowered on a vertical jet of water. For those who are familiar with that beautiful film, The Sound of Music, you will possibly recognize many of the following scenes which appeared in the film. Let us excursion a little away from the city to one of Austria's beautiful lake resorts, Zell am See, where on this beautiful weekend the people were making the most of their freedom. The Zeller See is not fed with any glacier water. Consequently, it warms rapidly in summer to 20 degrees Celsius or 68 degrees Fahrenheit. cable car ride from the town up the mountain provides one with a wonderful panorama of the lake and surrounding mountains. After leaving Tel Amzay, we turned to the little village of Lofa before returning to Salzburg. The village, with a Loferer Steinberger delicately chiseled behind the church tower, makes a delightful picture. From one end to the other of the twisting village high street may be seen the comfortable and cared for houses. Lofa is the starting point for many excursions among the alpine pastures. Before our passport to Salzburg expires, let us return to look over this beautiful city and the River Salzach, the city which gave the world Mozart and his music.